Hey everyone, it's Ben back from Living Survival, and today we're going to take a look at the M-Gear Gadget Wallet. So this is M-Gear's Gadget Wallet. It's a fully customizable, small EDC-style wallet. There's been a few of these on the market. You know, they have Kydex ones, which in my opinion have always been sort of bulky. We've reviewed the Ridge card before, which is really nice. It's really just the size of a credit card, and I do like that one. So I wanted to check this one out from M-Gear, and again, the nice thing about this one is that it is fully customizable. So I'm going to break it down here and we can go through the different options of it. The quality and construction, as far as I can tell and for as long as I've been using it, is really nice. It does hold up real well. It has just, you know, this square shape, so it does hold, you know, does pocket nicely, and it does feel nice when you go to pull it out. And also people comment on it too. Again, fully customizable. So let me pop these out. There is these two tabs here. They call them their ejector plates. So there's one sort of facing this way and there's one sort of facing that way so that you can put cards on both sides. But let's go ahead and eject everything I have out of here. I do have a couple cards in here and they're multi-tool. And then I have a couple of their money clip, which slides on the back. But let's break this thing down to its basic. This is where you're gonna start as a basic wallet. I believe this one will hold up to 10 cards. You can see here on the plates that there is spacers in there, so you could remove one of those spacers and it would make it smaller. It would hold only about 5 cards. Generally, I'm only carrying about 5 to 8 cards and then some cash. So this, you know, a wallet like this works really well. I've been carrying a minimal wallet like this for a while now. So this would be the basic configuration. Now you can get the front and back plates configured however you want. There's different textures. There's different styles of that. You can see this one just has the M-Gear logo in it. They do have all different types of styles on their website, as well as you can customize this front plate and put your own logo on it if you wanted to do that. On the back plate, you do have the ID window here. Again, the back plate sort of matches the pattern of the front plate. Those are fully customizable. I believe they have over 16 different colors and textures available. So that's the basics of the wallet. You can put it in this sort of extended, or you could take one of those spacers out and put it in a more minimal, slim version. But even at its, you know, even at its expansion here, it's still quite thin. And then you just have the two ejector plates. Now these are metal ejector plates, and you can see they're kind of housed in there, so they're not going to fall out, you know, when you go to use the wallet. So stepping up from, you know, sort of the basic design here, you'd have this and you'd have, you know, your cards here. You can get these RFID cards. They are not only RFID blocking, but they also have one's a measurement and one's maybe a signaling, I believe, card. So a couple of handy cards in there. So basically what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to slide these in to this to the front portion here. And then since there's only two cards in there, you know, they are quite loose. But once you get, you know, 3 or 4 more cards in there, it's going to be nice and snug. And then you just go ahead and you push this ejector plate and out come your cards. So you can push the whole stack out and then you kind of just go through them like a deck of cards. And it does work really well. It's real similar to the Ridge wallet where you push on the corner and they kind of fan out and you pick one that way. So I didn't find any issues with that at all. And that did work out really nice. And then you could take your ID and you could put that in the back portion here, and you've got an ID window. So on one side you have your cards, on the back maybe you have your ID, and you could put that in the back window as well. Another upgrade that you can get would be this money clip. It's a money clip / pocket clip. It does have an RFID blocking measurement card sort of glued to it. And then there's also this little stash pocket, I guess you could call it, or stash little cutout here. This happens to come with a little Fresnel lens, which is kind of cool, but you could take that out and then you could stick a key in there or coins in there. So you could put, you know, that in like that and store, house a key in there, maybe just a backup key, or put some coins in there. I didn't ever really use that like that. And, you know, with me having like 10 cards, I didn't even use the money clip portion of it. I just used the, you know, 5 cards on each side of the wallet here. But that's also an upgrade option to get the money clip. And basically that would just slide in to where the window is here, and it just clicks there. So then you have your cards on the one side of the wallet that you can push out, and then you have your money clip on the other side. They also have a couple survival tools, is what they call them, or multi-tools. This one, I believe, is their 18-in-1. It has a couple different features, you know, a bottle opener here, a cord cutter, a couple little hex bits, a couple other bits on this side, screwdrivers, a ruler, and a sharpened edge right here, so it would work as a knife. Again, since I have, you know, 10 cards or so, I found it that this was just a little bit too thick to have in there, but you could slide it in there just like that, and it would work really well as that. So, you know, real simple, really easy and really compact, really lightweight, and again with the customization options, it makes it really cool. They also do have a additional component where you could get a flashlight sleeve on the side. I believe they have carabiner clips that you can get, so there's all different types of little extra things that you can get, but I like to keep it just nice and basic. So for me, I just keep it, you know, without the money clip on it. You can see the wallet that I have been using. It's just this little pouch from CountyCom. Love this little thing. Very basic, very minimal, but you can see that the M-Gear wallet is actually a little bit smaller. So it's maybe about, you know, 3/4 of an inch smaller. And I never really did use the clip on the back of this at all. It's not removable. You know, you don't really feel it in your pocket at all. But so on the M-Gear wallet, you know, I take that out and just place my ID on this side. So I have quick access to my cards, and then I have a quick access to my ID or fishing license or, you know, concealed firearm permit, whatever you want to put on there. You could keep these RFID cards, one on the front and one on the back, and then it's going to completely block your cards from being, from the data being stolen off them. This is typically the stack of cards that I usually am carrying on me. I believe it's about 10 cards. So I can take 5 of those and put them on top, 5 of those and put them on bottom. I'm going to go ahead and do that off camera real quick, and then I will show you what that looks like. So that's how it looks with my cards on the inside. I do have the RFID blocker card on the top there. So again, with the ejector plate in the bottom, I can just simply pull that out, and then I can go through my cards really easily. And then on the back side with the ID window, I do have my ID, so I could quickly slide that out and get to that as well. So again, bunch of different customization options, and you guys can check that all out on their site. But I thought this was a really cool wallet. I believe these start at like $39, depending on how you want to customize them on up. And yeah, so that is the M-Gear Gadget Wallet, and makes a nice wallet for anybody who wants to minimize what they carry on a daily basis. You can certainly do that with this.
So of course there will be links below where you guys can check out more from M-Gear. You can check out the different front plates and back plates, the different textures and colors that you can get with the Gadget Wallet. So again, there will be a link below. I hope you guys give this video a big thumbs up for me. Make sure you leave me a comment in the comment section below and share this video to any friends or family on your social media who you think might be interested. Those shares and comments do go a long way to help support my channel. And if you haven't already done so, please click that red subscribe button and that notification bell to be notified of new videos.